What is the objective of all the sadhanas that we do? All of the sadhanas that we do, whether it is bhajan singing, study circle, soup kitchens, disaster management and relief, all of these activities that we do have an objective. What is that objective? That objective is actually the job of what the washing machine does. In India, it is called the dhobi or the washerman. The job of all the sadhanas is actually the job of the washing machine. What the washing machine does, it is to cleanse the impressions which have been accumulated in our mind over so many lifetimes. Every action and interaction that we undertake with our five senses creates an impression in our mind. And our mind has the capacity to store as much data as the entire Facebook across the world. The capacity it has to save, that much capacity of storage we have as an individual. This I am not saying, this Professor Kasturi Rangan, who was the chairman of the Indian Space Research Organization and came to Swami's university as the chief guest for the convocation, had said that during his address. That is the quantum of impressions we have carried over several lifetimes. And it is these impressions which block our vision. So what should we do? We do all of the kinds of sadhanas. What is the objective of the sadhana? So that's the caveat. All of these activities need to be done selflessly without any expectations in reward. If they are done to get some reward, then this objective also will not be achieved. So what is the objective these sadhanas are meant to be achieving? The objective of all of these sadhanas is to wipe the dirt that has been accumulated on our subconscious mind in terms of a variety of impressions over several lifetimes. So whatever we do, that is the ultimate objective. Whichever path we select, this is the ultimate objective. If all of these impressions are washed off, which means if we are slowly transforming ourselves, what are these impressions? These impressions are of anger, of impatience, of jealousy, of greed, of pride. It is a permutation and combination of these six vices which are constantly harrowing us. It's just millions of permutations and combinations of these six vices. So when it is done selflessly, what happens? These vices or these negative impressions slowly start getting diluted. I'll give you an experience example here. A huge batch of youth, young adults from one of the Indian states had done a lot of service activities in a particular area, in the rural areas. And Swami gave them an interview. And in that interview, this youth, young adults were sharing all these details. So many people were fed, so many people were served, so many people were trained, educated, etc., etc. Swami said, very good, I'm very happy. But answer my question. After doing all these service activities, has your anger reduced? Has your jealousy reduced? Has your pride reduced? Has your compassion increased? Has your tolerance and patience increased? If it has increased, then the purpose of doing these service activities has been achieved to some extent. If that has not happened, then doing all of these activities is of no use. So the objective of all of these activities is to cleanse ourselves and transform ourselves. So once through all these sadhanas, our chitta or our subconscious mind is cleaned. You can compare it with a mirror which is covered with lot of dust. When all of the dust is cleaned and cleared and the mirror becomes spotlessly clean, what happens? The Atma, the Jiva, which is there inside us, reflects itself in the chitta. It's able to see, it's the closest. And that's when in the mirror of our mind, we are able to see our divine identity. That actually is what is called self-realization. We have realized that we are the self. Why were we not able to realize? Because the dust on our subconscious mind, which has been accumulated by our actions over several lifetimes, had prevented us from seeing our true identity. The mirror was blocked. But the moment the mirror was cleaned, this identity was revealed. That is truly self-realization. It is called Sarparajju Bhranti in Vedanta. You are walking on a road. There is less light. You see a wavy substance. You think it is a snake. You get scared. Then you take out the torch that you had. You switch on the torch. Then you realize it is not a snake. It is a rope. I'm safe. Did that snake become a rope because you switched on the light? No, that was always a rope because of your ignorance. You were not able to see that as a rope. You thought it was a snake. But when the wisdom of the light came on, you realized this is a rope. Similarly, we are all always divine. It is because of all these negative impressions that have been imposed on us over several lifetimes, we are not able to understand our true nature. If you are going to a cinema hall and because there is no light, you only see those impressions coming out from the projector, the movie projector. On the huge screen, you will see all of these people fighting, crying, romancing, enjoying, etc., etc. Suddenly, the light comes on. All of those multicolored, beautiful images vanish, and all you see is a white screen. Through the slit of your mind, with the limited knowledge that you have, you're perceiving this world, and hence you see all this variety. But the moment the knowledge dawns on you, and the slit of the mind is opened up, it becomes a gush of white light, and all of that is seen as white light. The screen is white. And you realize that it was a white screen. It was always a white screen. All of these superimpositions of this particular movie were only illusions. This is true self-realization. When the wisdom comes on, we realize that we were always divine. We are not this fair skin or dark skin or an aggressive or a timid or a humble or a pompous individual. These are superimpositions on us. We are actually the white screen on which all these superimpositions play out.